agricultural marketing practices. This paper is jointly authored by one of my students, Pallavi Mukherjee, and myself, Dr. Sanita Abbey. And to start with, I'd like to give a brief introduction that this paper basically examines the awareness level and the willingness of the consumers to adopt green product and green marketing practices. And I've tried to analyze that how the what are the consumers' perception regarding the green agriculture product as well as green marketing practices. And green marketing has emerged as the latest trend in marketing all over the world in recent times. And the customers nowadays are concerned about how their usage of any product and services affects the environment positively or negatively, whether it is degrading the environment or not. Even government at different levels and industry are working towards changing the preferences of the public to adopt environmentally sustainable products and practices. And for example, in case of agriculture also, they want to make prevalent the practices like drip irrigation, and this basically covers the whole entire cycle from farm to fork in its entirety, and they want to regenerate soil with natural ingredients, and plus they want that the product should reach the ultimate consumer in a sustainable manner. So these are the objectives that to check the awareness of the consumer regarding green marketing practices, to see what are the issues and challenges of green marketing practices, and what are the consumer preferred brands for green marketing, and what are the factors motivating the consumers to buy green products. And this is a brief literature review where Sanjay K.J. and Gurmeet Kaur have discussed about the business firms. Skip. Okay, so I've used primary data. So I've done critical evaluation and analysis of primary data, and I've collected the information from 101 consumers for UP district. And for reliability of questionnaire, I have taken the value of Cronbach alpha. And I've taken the using multiple regression model also in order to see the impact of different variables on purchase behavior as well as on the green values. And I've used simple tools like mean standard deviation and multiple regression. Okay, so this is regarding the sources of information that mostly the customers or the consumers get to know about the green marketing practices through internet or through media. That is 60.4% from internet and 13.9% from media, but that is just for my sample size, that is 101 consumers. Next is that we asked about the consumer perceptions about the green products. In this case, they give high importance to the manufacturer. We think that the green marketing practice of manufacturing the product in an eco-friendly manner is one of the important factors which leads to the green marketing practices. And plus, they want that they should use eco-friendly mode of communication in order to promote the product. As well, they want that we should manufacture products which are eco-friendly. So these are the green marketing practices which the consumers tend to follow. And in this case, we can see that the consumers are very concerned about the wastage of resources, and they are also considering that how we should be acting more as environmentally responsible. And the products should not harm the environment. That is 3.81b. Next is the multiple regression analysis. In this case, I have seen the impact of awareness, green practices, as well as green values on the purchase behavior. In this case, the green practices statements as well as the green values, they are significant. If we see the purchase behavior, as their key value is quite high. Three values low, and it is green practice significant at 1%, whereas that green values is significant at 10% level, and even the R square is showing 0.93% variation. That 93% variations are showing the impact of the variables on the purchase behavior. Similarly, I've seen the impact of age and gender on the green value statement. In this case, only age came out to be significant at 1% level, and gender has come to be significant but the R-square was low, that is 160, because this is the primary data, that is why the R-square is coming to low. And again, I've asked about the association of the green marketing or green produce or green products with the brands. In this case, people were not much aware about the green marketing brands like Organic India, Fab India, Organic Food Company. These are some of the brands or companies that have come over time associated themselves with the green marketing practices, but the consumers or the respondents, they were not able to recall the name of the brands which are related to the green marketing practices. And according to the survey, around 78% of the consumer had the willingness to buy green products if they become the part of the necessary commodity list. And on a scale of 5, this green score came out to be 3.8. And it was noticed that there is a dire need for better promotion of green products for the consumers. So these were the main problems of green marketing practices. The major problem was that there was not much knowledge about the green marketing practices, and even the availability of green products in the shop is not easily available. Even they face the problem, and they said that even the prices are quite high when it comes to the organic food, and they want that the people should attain the economies of scale and try to reduce the prices of the organic products so that it could be available to the market. And in the last, I would like to say that since some of the works are being done by the state as well as the state and central government regarding the green marketing practices, but people are not much aware about it. Awareness should be done through the media, and if they are aware, then they understand the need for adopting green practices, and they are concerned about the high prices and availability of green products, and that is why they want that the green products should come into the necessity list. And it gives a good focus on the consumer's behavior regarding the green products.
Discussion in the wheat markets obviously will affect the sustainability in the long run. So our purpose of this study is to probe the reasons for the price differences in specialty separated markets. So what is the extent of integration and whether that integration will help for sustainable market development. So this is the focus of our study. So we have used second data for 15 major wholesale markets in India. So our data spans from July 2002 to June 2017, the agricultural year. We have used different, this data has been collected from the Almanac network, the wholesale monthly prices. So we have used this methodology. So first we found out the dynamics in the prices of wheat, like using ASP, that is average seasonal price variation, intra-year price rise and coefficient variation. We have also found out growth rates in original prices as well as seasonal index. Then we have found out the level of market integration using the popular governance test. Then if markets are integrated, then which market is causing which food? That price transmission is has been found out in the corporate test. And finally, we have come out with the law of one price. That theory applies practically in wheat markets. So this is the analytical steps we have used in our study. So first we started with the limit group testing using augmented digital test, then we went for co-integration using multiple Jorgensen method, then third Langer Cross-Sorting test, and finally long term price. So here our the ideology is price integration should exist so that it will lead to better market performance. Once the market performance is put or up to the mark, then it will lead to sustainable market development. This is the basic philosophy of our study. This is the findings from our research. So the figure shows that the growth, or you can say almost all the markets exhibited positive growth in wholesale prices, and it was highest in Punjab and Uttarakhand. And regarding the average price or minimum or maximum price, it was highest in Kerala, because Kerala is basically not a wheat producing state but it is a consuming state. So because of that reason the prices are very high. And regarding the So regarding the other statistical parameters, you see the skewness, it is positively skewed with the exception of Maharashtra, Kerala and Odisha. And regarding the kurtosis, this practically means that the distribution is a bit slower than statistically. And when we work out the Kadidela index, that is taking care of trend or